Okay, we're going to install WordPress on your server. After you've uploaded the WordPress installation files and base files up to your website through your web host, you're going to want to go to your URL, and then this site's going to show up first. And you're going to want to click on Create a Configuration File. This is the prerequisite stuff it's going to ask you before you install. So you're going to click here on Let's Go. And this is the stuff that you're going to get from your web host. This is your database information from MySQL. You're going to want to retain your database name, your username, your password, and sometimes in some instances you're going to want to keep your database host too. A list of them is right here. If you are on 1&1, DreamHost, GoDaddy, ICDSoft, Media Template Grid Server, Pear Networks, Rackspace Cloud, Yahoo, or TopHost, there's a chance that you might actually be changing the database host information. But in this example, we won't really need to. So, okay, I'm going to enter my username and my password, and my database host is staying the same. It's going to be localhost. Your table prefix is used in case that you need to install more than one WordPress in one database. Sometimes this is useful if you're creating a lot of small blogs and you don't need to have a ton of databases sitting on your web host. If you're going to create a larger blog, however, it might be better if you go ahead and do a separate database for it, though. After your information is in, you're going to hit submit. And if everything runs and checks out okay with your web host, this should show up. Otherwise, it'll say error establishing database connection. So you want to run the install. This is where it actually puts all the tables in the database. Okay, and here's your blog. Here is my and your email address. And usually you want to keep this checked if you're going to have a public blog. Install WordPress. And here's your username and password. You are all set.